Hi everybody, my name is Paul Grimes, Village Manager of Orland Park. Welcome to the National Night Out for 2014. We hope you enjoy the filming and some of the sights and sounds of this year's National Night Out.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is David Holzinger. I'm a police officer here in Orland Park. I'm also a member of the South Suburban Emergency Response Team, where I hold the position of a sniper team leader. What we have over here for display today is some of the equipment that I would normally bring out on some of our operations and some of our training days. We'll start over on this side over here. This is one of the backpacks that we'll bring out. Inside the backpacks, pretty much everything that I'm going to need to use during an operation, like if a barricaded subject or something like that. I've got everything from rifle rests to chairs to food to rain gear, anything that I'm going to need if we're out there for hours on end, which we normally are. Over here in the backers, we have the rifle that I use. It's an Accuracy International. It's made out of England. It's a .308 caliber rifle. It's very accurate. This rifle scope on here is made by Leupold. It's able to magnify up to 14 times, so I'm able to get a really good visual on whatever my target is, whether I'm observing a front door or looking to see if anybody's moved any drapes or screens on the inside, or if anybody's moving around on the inside. Up in the front here, we have my 5.56 caliber rifle that I carry on patrol. It's issued by the department. It's one of the rifles that we carry in addition to the shotguns on the street. We're starting to move away from shotguns, giving these rifles, because they're a lot easier for us to shoot and they're a lot accurate. We move over here further towards the right. This is some of the gear that we'll be carrying on our operations. We always have gas masks with us in case we have to deploy gas in some way or another for somebody that's refusing to come out. We'll always go with a less lethal option in order to get them to come out and surrender. Over here we have different types of ballistic vests that we'll carry. This is a plate carrier. What it has in here is it has ballistic ceramic plates in there that will help stop rifle rounds. And then the pouches that are on the front of here carry some of my equipment, whether it's extra magazines, a tourniquet, first aid supplies over here just in case somebody gets injured. This would be one of the entry vests that we'll use if we're going to be doing high-risk warrants on the inside of a house. This has a lot more equipment on it because I'll normally carry this when I'm doing sniper duties, where I need less equipment on me at the time, whereas if I'm doing entry team stuff, I need a lot more. So I have everything from screwdrivers to Leatherman tools to extra ammunition for my pistol as well as my rifle. I have a holster over there on the right that would hold my my sidearm, and then extra first aid kit. Ear protection in case they're using flashbangs going on the inside. This way that helps protect my hearing. Simplistic helmets that we use. They're rifle and pistol rated, and on the front here we have night vision so that we're able to see during low light and no light. We'll usually wear this when we're coming up towards where the house we're at to make sure that there's nobody looking at us first. Over here in the far right we just have one of the tripods that I use for when I'm doing long distance shooting. It helps to support the rifle as I'm standing or sitting or kneeling behind it. And that's pretty much a description of some of the equipment that we bring out with us on a SWAT operation, whether it's a high-risk warrant or a barricaded subject type of a call.
Wasn't that fun? I couldn't hear you. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, men and women, boys and girls of all ages. How's everyone doing tonight? Would everybody say fantastic? And how many of you are magicians? Let's give the junior magicians a big round of applause. But a little loud. You know, children, there's magic in all of us. There's magic in me, magic in you, magic in your parents, your grandparents. We all are blessed with our own special magic. My name is Mr. D, and children, my first magic show was when I was a Cub Scout. I was 8 years old when I did my first magic show. And the best place to learn magic, does anybody know? The libraries. Go to the libraries and get books, and then you can make magic with things you can find around your home. Cards, coins, pieces of paper, pieces of string. I would like to see if we can get a helper. All of you kids want to help. Well, you can help the DJ in a little bit. He'll have a game where everybody can help. Right now, I need someone that can follow directions real well. How about the little girl right there? Come on up. Hurry, hurry, hurry. She runs the other way. That's what we call stage fright. Okay, let's see. How about this little girl with the orange pants on, the orange shorts? Come on up, honey. Hurry, hurry, hurry. What's your name?
Marisha.
Give Marisha a big round of applause. Now, I found this, children, at a rummage sale. It's sort of a happy-looking toy. It has, what color is this? What color is this one? Okay, let me put the mic right here. The red one is attached to the green one, and the blue one is attached to the yellow one. Could you stand right over here, honey? Now, if you were going to do a magic at someone's birthday party, the first thing you would need is a magic wand. And then, which color would you choose? Tell everybody. The blue one or the yellow one?
Yellow.
Are you sure? Wave the magic wand around the yellow one and say, don't smack it, just wave it around there. Say your favorite magic word.
Abracadabra.
Okay, now do me a favor. Remember, children, the red one is attached to the green one. But since you said abracadabra and you're using a magic wand, pull the yellow one down slowly. Wait a minute, the green one went up. How did you do that?
I don't know.
You did that with your magic, little girl, because you have magic, don't you?
Yeah.
And how did you do it? With your magic, tell everybody. How did you do it?
With my magic.
Okay, we're going to get it going a little bit better here. Remember, we got a green one, a red one, the yellow one's attached to the blue one. Which one you want to use this time? Tell everybody, the red one or the green one?
Green.
Are you sure? Can I talk you into the red one?
Yeah.
Or do you want to use the green one?
Green.
Okay, wave the magic wand around the green one. Say your favorite magic word.
Abracadabra.
Okay, pull the green one down slowly. Wait a minute, the yellow one went up. How did you do that?
From my magic.
Everybody, come on by, come on by. You gotta get back where you were for the Mr. D show, because the Sandberg Color Guard has been training all summer for the upcoming marching band season. Ladies and gentlemen, please remember that this is a work in progress. Sit back and enjoy tonight's presentations.
Next in the Big and Easy series is a dynamic yet very playable arrangement of our national march, Stars and Stripes Forever, and it's arranged by Mike Story.
is first on different pieces of equipment. Here's a little something they can do with a rifle. This is a popular tune you may recognize. Yeah.